glass boat hull, the configuration of the glass boat hull. To my knowledge, in 1960, that was registered as a trademark in the United States, and also later in some other countries. But when the owner came to China to register the trademark, he was refused because we only protect two-dimensional trademark, no three-dimensional trademark.
Which is the title, Coca-Cola, and?
Oh, no, just the configuration of the glass bottle, not the plastic one now available in the market. And also for the sounds or smells, you know that we only have a short history to protect a trademark. That was not, that are not available for the, for you to register as a trademark.
But in the States, three-dimensional trademarks are all protected.
That's correct. I mean, in the States, again, we have a much more developed system, as China does. China is developing, the system is developing, and that's grown out of, you know, history. But initially, again, we were looking at one-dimensional objects, much like China is today, and then it developed into a, when there were secondary meanings with marks that immediately identified it for a product, then that got protection, that got status. And I think under WTO, and I think Professor Lee is right, under WTO, China will change into having multidimensional marks, but probably not go as far as having sound and other types of things, smells, being protected. But it's a system that was worked well in the United States so far.
You know that in the WTO TRIPS agreement, there is a provision. It requires the membership countries or members to protect the trademark as visual acceptable signs